welcome back in the studio. And now it's time to speak about the master program Economic Data Analysis. It's not a new program, it has already a big tradition. And I have here again a guest, student of this program, Fahad Fayaz. So welcome, Fahad. I am really happy you came.
Hello, Veronica.
And my very first question is, why did you choose to study EDA program?
I chose EDA program because of my strong interest and ambition to engage in empirical work. I would say the curriculum of economic data analysis program focuses on mainly on data analysis part, data visualization, programming languages, and besides that on statistical methods. So these skills are highly valued in the job market.
Yeah, great. And you are already now in the second year studies, in the third semester, just now finishing. So I guess you can evaluate the program a little bit because just very soon you will already finish the studies. So how do you like the program?
Well, the program is interesting and sometimes quite challenging. I would say it's a blend of econometrics and data science. So one gets a chance to explore the dynamics of both the subjects.
Good. And what are the key courses of the program? What are the key subjects?
The key courses of the program are regression, advanced econometrics, we have time series, and probability and statistics. In lecture classes, we mainly stress on theoretical aspects of modeling, whereas in seminar classes, we work with real-world data and do some statistical testing and analysis using R programming mainly.
Yeah, so if I understand it correctly, the courses are just combining both the theory and the practice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah,
good. And what are the usual job positions of the graduates of the EDA program?
The job positions available are data scientist, data analyst, also a quantitative analyst. The seniors who graduated from this program, they are mainly working in reputed multinational companies as a data scientist.
So, mm-hmm. And really to work as data scientist, it's a very, very well-paid position. So if you are, again, good in math, if you are good in statistics, definitely apply to this program. Your career options are definitely very good, isn't that?
Exactly.
And the EDA program has two specializations, data analysis and modeling, and official statistics. In this program, you just apply in the end, and within the first semester, you have to check, you have to choose your specialization. You study official statistics,
exactly.
Isn't that?
Yes.
And how do you like this specialization?
Well, I choose official statistics because I believe this will help me and enhance my skills in statistics. Furthermore, it gives me an opportunity to examine the European data in different ways. Additionally, specialization in official statistics gives an opportunity to earn an additional supplementary degree, which is known as Master in Official Statistics. And this is awarded by the European Statistical System Committee.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, good. So if I understand correctly, if you finish the official statistics, then you will receive two diplomas.
Okay.
One is yours and the second one is the European Master in Official Statistics. Just within this program, you have to go on within the third semester on an internship where you have been.
I have been to Czech Statistical Office. During this internship program, I was being assigned one research project through and the guide and the my supervisor was assigned to me, and I worked under the team. It was mainly I was involved in macroeconomic statistics division. I learned to navigate through complex data sets, and I did analysis part and empirical work too. So it was a great opportunity because you're getting involved with great minds who are involved in macroeconomic statistics at Statistical Office.
Yeah, good. I saw we had there questions from chat. We will answer it soon, but first I want to give you another question. We now spoken about the official statistics specialization, and the second specialization is economic data analysis. What you can say about this specialization?
The second specialization is data analysis and modeling. This modeling is mainly focusing on the advanced data training and techniques. So, but the best thing is that you in the third semester, students mainly spend their third semester abroad, which is funded by Erasmus program. So you don't need to pay any additional tuition fees for that. Even you're getting a scholarship to cover the day-to-day expenses. So you can at least spend your third semester in your United States of America, United Kingdom. So this blend of advanced training skill sets and at the same time international experience makes it a unique opportunity for students.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you very much. So if you choose official statistics, you will go an internship in the second semester, and then the third semester, isn't that?
Yeah.
Which make again just like a little bit interesting for your CV, even for your future career. And if you choose the second specialization, then you may go in Erasmus on one of our partnerships. Now I want to go to back to the questions from the chat, which we just now received. Here was the question, we have some native speakers, English speakers, do they need to upload any special documents for the language eligibility?
No, I don't think students need any IELTS exam for that if you are you have a native language.
Maybe I would just like to add, in case you are native speakers, it really depends also from which country you are. It's always better if you will please upload a document stating that you finish your bachelor's degree in English. That's for us really approved. So even if you are native speakers, it's better please to upload a bachelor's degree. Usually there is a diploma supplement written that you did the studies in English, and that's like the proof which we need. Another thing is it difficult to find a job after the graduation?
No, I don't believe it's difficult to find a job in Czech Republic, because if you go through the statistics, the unemployment rate in Czech Republic is very low compared to many European countries. So if you have a good skill set, so you'll easily land a job in Czech Republic. Mm-hmm.
And also many of our students are working while studies. Mm-hmm. Do you have also a job?
Yes, we can easily work as a part-time in Czech Republic, because our timetable is advantageous in this regard, because we have classes scheduled for 3 days a week. So there is a flexibility to find a job, part-time job.
Mm-hmm. And also the visa allow you to work part-time.
Exactly.
So definitely
yes.
It's possible, mm-hmm. Isn't that? And I would say that maybe, 80-90% of students who are working part-time. And my very last questions on you is, what are your future plans? Will you stay in Prague after the graduation, or will you move home?
This is quite a difficult question, but I believe after completing my degree, I'll try to be in Prague for a couple of years to enhance and use the skills I learned in this program in corporate sector. And maybe later on, I'll head back to my home country and I might start a political journey there.
Yeah, that's very interesting. So I would like to wish you good luck with
thank
that,
so
of
much.
Course. And thank you very much that you came here to the studio and answered the questions from the applicants. Thank you a lot. And you can still send the questions on Fahad Fayaz. He will be still in the room next to the studio. So he will just now be there to answer the questions in the chat. So thank you. And now we will speak about the program Information System Management.